in Cleo, across from the depot. I stood on her, she took off her ring. I thought I'd get closer, so I walked on over, sat down and asked her name. When the drinks finally hit her, she said, "I'm no quitter, but I finally quit living on dreams. Hungry for laughter here ever after, I'm after whatever life brings." In the mirror I saw him, and I closely watched him. I thought how he looked out of place. Look on his face. His big hands were calloused. He looked like a mountain. For a minute I thought I was dead. He started shaking. His big heart was broken. He turned to the woman and said, "You picked a fine time to leave, Lucille. With 4 hungry children and a crop in the field, I've had some bad times, lived through some sad times. This time you're hurting, won't appeal. You picked a fine time to leave me, Lucille." After he left us, I ordered more whiskey. I thought how she made him look small. From the lights of the bar room to a rented hotel room, we walked without talking at all. She was a beauty, but when she came to me, she must have thought I'd lost my mind. I did. I couldn't hold her, but the words that he told her kept coming back time after time. "You picked a fine time to leave me, Lucille. With 4 hungry children and a crop in the field. I've had some bad times, lived through some sad times. This time you picked a fine time to leave me, Lucille. You picked a fine time to leave me, Lucille."